welcome back.
It is good to put up things that are necessary and that will put you ahead when someone opens your CV. How about the don'ts? What should you not do? And this is what I see mostly when I open up CVs. So come and see the things that you should not, do not include this in your CV as you send it out in job hunting. You don't need to show a photo of yourself on the CV. Not necessary. 2, salary. How much salary you are earning or are earning, not necessary in the CV or resume that you choose. 3, also, stay away from saying the reason why you left the previous position. Not a detail, not a necessary detail in a CV. Other things that are not necessary that you don't need to show are things like your hobbies, religion, language, not necessary. Marital status. I always find that it is not necessary for me to see whether you're single, engaged, married with 2 children, not necessary. So those ones, stay away from showing. They are unnecessary. They just take too much time. And in other cases, they just make interviewer or the prospective employer a little bit biased.
Why weren't you called? Why would an employer sit without even having looked at anything much and decide that they are not going to contact you? Here are some of the reasons why an employer would not get back to you. 1, which is really a very common problem. There was no attachment in your cover letter. So there is no attachment, there is no contact. This person is not able to look at what it is that you say. No working phone number. 2, the numbers that you give on these documents, tafadhali, the numbers that you give, please let them be numbers that work. 1, it is not working. 2, it is not available for days on end. Not available for days on end and you're looking for a job. 3, it is with someone who is of someone and of someone. You have given huyu mtu, apana ntamuita. So the employer begins to tire out calling somebody who is going to look for you and call you. Keep a phone and keep it on. And please be consistent with your numbers. Your referees, the people you said are references and can be able to qualify what you said in your CV or resume, are not available. Either they don't remember you, or they don't remember anything that you're doing or where you have been. Keep updating your referees. Keep updating. Because once you call one person and ask them about this person, then if they're not available to vouch for you, then we will not call you. Poor formatting. Again, poor formatting, and most of us have been victims of a CV that was good, but it gonna format too bad. Nobody can look at it twice. It became too busy, and this person has got hundreds and hundreds of CVs to look at. So there must have been some irrelevance to the position that you applied for. Now, I have sat and asked for and advertised positions for a welder or a machinist. And a lady who has done a diploma in mass communication applies. For sure, we will not get back to you. No contact. You didn't leave any contact, or maybe after a week or two, the contacts could not be retraced. Again, that is the most common problem. You know, we have shortlisted. We feel this person, we should get back to them, but they did not leave a contact. So look at your document again. Look that you have put in the numbers correctly. You have done attachments. Your phone numbers are working. Please don't do reverse calls. When you find a missed call from an employer, then you do a reverse call. Kindly, please don't do that. So that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed much about this type of things. We will continue to inform you more on the very many mistakes that come with CV writing and job hunting. But for now, thank you for watching. Stay tuned, like, share, and subscribe.